thank you very much. And first, I'd like to thank the organizers to give me the opportunity of this talk in this such a nice conference. And my name is Yosuke Matsumoto from ISSB, University of Tokyo. And today, I would like to talk about the novel quantum criticality found in the Valence Fluctuating YbAlB4 system and its topological aspects. So I think that this maybe can be related to the summary of hexaboride, which is a main topic of this conference. These are my collaborators. And this is the outline of my talk. And first, I would like to introduce the conventional idea of quantum criticality, which is a magnetic quantum criticality if in FA electron intermediary. And after that, I would like to talk about, discuss how the anomalous behavior found in equilibrium boron-4 systems are different from the conventional observation. And then I'd like to discuss the topological effect due to the massive hybridization. And then further, I'd like to talk about some related observations. And then if I have time, I'd like to briefly mention about the topological aspects in the in metallic spinite system, processing 2, leading 2, or 7. So let me start with the introduction of the basic conventional idea. So first of all, the quantum critical point is the second order phase transition that takes place at t equals 0. And as shown here in the schematic phase diagram, if we suppress the order phase by tuning control parameters such as pressure, field, or doping, then the critical point appears on the border of order phase. And this is very interesting because a lot of unusual states have been found in the vicinity of this QCP, such as non-ferrolytic and unconventional superconductivity. And F-electron systems are quite the ideal system to study quantum criticality because the system has a small energy scale. So therefore, it is relatively easy to tune the system, the ground state of the system, by using field pressure, chemical doping, so on. And another advantage is that the fact that the high quality samples are available. And there is one and only established example, which is the magnetic QCP. This is arising from the competition between Kondo effect and RPPO interaction. In the Kondo effect, the local moment, the F moment, is screened by conduction. On the other hand, in the RPPO interaction, so in this case, the F moments are, so this is the interaction between F moments through the conduction vector. And these two are complete. And this can be schematically understood by the so-called Donyak phase diagram, as shown here. And indeed, there are a lot of examples of Donyak-like phase diagrams shown here. And as you can see here, there are a lot of examples of this the unconventional heavy field superconductivity found in the vicinity of the magnetic QCP. However, so far, all quantum critical materials in the family of heavy fermion intermetallics are Kondo lattice systems with almost integral valence and related to a magnetic QCP. And on the other hand, as we demonstrated recently, the unconventional quantum criticality can be also possible in the mixed valence systems. And in the YB case, the 3 plus is magnetic and 2 plus is non-magnetic. And if we have, if the system has the variance somewhere in between the system is supposed to be. It's called mixed variance. And these systems are expected to have a large TK. And here, this is the example found in the YbAlB4. And in this case, the Yb variance is estimated to be 2.7. And TK is also estimated to be order of 300 Kelvin. Below this large TK, the system exhibits the parameter and the specificity is also small, not so large. And basically, the system is supposed to be quite away from the magnetism, and the no or magnetic quantum criticality has been expected in these class of materials. So therefore, if we find something very interesting, quantum criticality in the mixed valence systems, so it should be coming from arising from the something beyond the Donyak phase diagram, and which is the case in the alpha and beta YbAlB4. And here I'd like to further discuss the possible topological effect arising from the anisotropic CF hybridization. So here the structure of the materials, and the both has the distorted excite made of iterium, and the both has the layer structure. However, the YbYb distance is the shortest around the C-axis, and the difference in the structure is the arrangement of the YB hexagon. In the case of beta phase, it aligned around the same direction as shown here. On the other hand, alpha phase exhibit the depth, so this kind of zigzag arrangement of the YB hexagon. And why the beta phase exhibit the first example of the heavy thermal superconductivity in the YB based systems, and also this exhibit the pronounced non-fermionic behavior at around zero field. On the other hand, the alpha phase has the fermionic ground state at zero field. However, this compound is also supposed to be close to quantum criticality because it exhibits quantum critical behavior if we dope iron to the aluminum side, or it exhibits metamagnetic drive behavior at the small magnetic field of 3 Tesla. And one prominent feature of this system is a strong valence fluctuation, which has been revealed by recent Hertzsprung measurement. This is the spectrum measured at 20 Kelvin. And the estimated YB variance at 20 Kelvin is 2.73 for alpha phase and 2.75 for beta phase. And in the case of beta phase, so we can say that this is the first example of the quantum criticality in mixed valence systems. And correspondingly, these two systems have a large temperature scale. Here, this is the temperature dependence of the resistivity, internal resistivity. As you can see here, if we subtract the normalizing contribution by using the lutetium ion model 4, then we can find a round peak at around 200 to 250 Kelvin. This is a coherence peak. And another observation is coming from the space heat. In the case of beta phase, it exhibits the logarithmic temperature dependence, and by using this equation, we can estimate the temperature scale of the order of 200 Kelvin, which is again consistent with the coherence peak temperature. And the last one is the most direct evidence of the large temperature scale of the YB variance. So this is coming from the temperature dependence of the YB variance measured by X-ray adsorption. As you can see here, it exhibits a monotonic decrease, and by using this one, so one can estimate the temperature scale of the order of 300 Kelvin. So indeed, these two systems has the large temperature scale, which is characteristic to valence fluctuating material. On the other hand, interestingly, these two systems exhibit a condor lattice behavior with a small temperature scale of 8 Kelvin. Here, this is a susceptibility, and the two systems exhibit almost identical susceptibility. And in this case, these two exhibit a Ising-like susceptibility with more data on the c-axis. And the c-axis susceptibility exhibits QE bias behavior far below the Valence temperature scale of the order of 300 Kelvin. So this is the inverse susceptibility. And as you can see here, the local momentum behavior passes far below the 300 Kelvin. And as you can see here, there's a shoulder-like feature at around 8 Kelvin. So this is the, we think this corresponds to the energy scale of the condor lattice. And below 8 Kelvin, while alpha become fermionic, the beta become non-fermionic. And another evidence of the condor lattice behavior is the large gamma specific heat of the order of 130 at 0.4 Kelvin. So the question is, how does the small temperature scale of 8 Kelvin coexist with a large temperature scale of 300 Kelvin? This is a quite important question, and this is not solved yet. And next, I'd like to discuss the novel quantum that can be found in the beta phase. Here, this is a summary of the non-fermionic behavior found in the beta phase at zero field, at around zero field. The infrared resistivity exhibits the temperature dependence of T to the 1.5, and the susceptibility exhibits T to the minus 0.5 divergent behavior. And the specific heat also exhibits the logarithmic divergent behavior. And if we apply a magnetic field, then the normal fermionic behavior becomes. And here, this is the contour plot of resistivity exponent defined by this equation. And as you can see here, the non-fermionic behavior is only restricted around zero field. And if we apply a magnetic field, the fermionic behavior immediately recovers. And if we and if you take a look at this one, so it looks like the quantum critical point is located just at zero field under ambient pressure. This is quite unusual behavior because normally we have to tune the control parameter such as magnetic field or pressure, like in other quantum critical materials. And this quantum critical point just located at zero field is further demonstrated by using a high precision magnetization measurement. And as you can see here, the sensitivity exhibits more and more divergent behavior approaching to zero field. And here, this is the temperature derivative of the sensitivity magnetization. And as you can see here, it shows a clear the power of behavior with a theta minus 1.5, which means the magnetization itself diverges with the temperature dependence of theta minus 0.5. At the TOB is much larger than 1. And at the TOB equal much smaller than 1, at the fermionic region, then we can see the fermionic behavior with minus DMDT proportional to T. And interestingly, if we plot the minus DMDT multiplied by B squared against TOB, then all the data below 2 tesla and 3 Kelvin shown here in this temperature field regime, all the data wraps on a single curve very nicely. So this means that the system exhibits this scaling behavior, TOB scaling. And this is indeed the scaling over 4 orders of TOB, quite a large okay, and in this temperature and field range, there's no intrinsic energy scale, which cannot be explained by a conventional SDW type QCD. And the scaling can be well explained by this equation, empirical scaling function. And if we assume a finite BC, and if we change this BC, we can check which BC gives the best fitting to the data. And as a result, the best width is less than 0.2 millimeters. So considering the experimental accuracy, this BC is practically zero and much, much smaller than the BC2 of the peripheral supercomputing found in this compound. So this is the first example of quantum peculiarity without tuning. And now the why this the BC equals zero in this system. The one the possibility is that the accidental scenario, the system is accidentally fine-tuned to the QCP. However, this small value, quite small value of the BC, the bound estimated here is quite small. And so therefore, we tend to believe that there is some mechanism such as the non-ferritic phase extending over finite pressure region. So therefore, what happens under pressure, or whether the non-ferritic behavior overstates pressure or not, is a quite important question. And indeed, the recent resistivity measurement under pressure revealed that there is such a phase extending over finite pressure region. And here, this is the contour plot of the resistivity exponent. And as you can see here, the non-ferritic behavior extending up to 0.4 GPa. And here, this is the resistivity exponent, the pressure dependence of the resistivity exponent. As you can see here, the anomalous exponent with a 1.5 passes up to 0.4 GPa and suddenly jump up to the normal value of 2.0. And here, in this pressure region, we have a ferroliquid. And in this ferroliquid region, interestingly, the A coefficient of the T squared temperature dependence is the diverging behavior towards this critical pressure. So there is a quantum phase transition at this critical pressure between strange metal phase and high field ferroliquid. And if we further pressurize the system, then the magnetic order appears. This magnetic ordering further confirmed by using this three-dimensional phase diagram. So here, we use the ion doping to the system, and if we dope ion to the aluminum side, then we can confirm the magnetic ordering even at the ambient pressure. And if we change the ion concentration, and if we change the pressure, then we can make this three-dimensional phase diagram. And if we take a look at this one, so the magnetic ordering found that the highly doped sample is smoothly connected to the one found in the pure compound. So we can say that this anomaly is also coming from the magnetic ordering. And if we take a look at this one, so this non-ferroliquid behavior is detached from the magnetic ordering. So one can say that this non-ferroliquid behavior is not associated with symmetric breaking of the phase, a broken symmetric phase transition. This is quite interesting. And so far, we don't know what is the origin. And however, there are some theoretical suggestions. And one is the valence quantum peculiarity. In this case, the QCP appears if the critical endpoint of the valence, the first level valence function is suppressed down to zero temperature. And in this case, this quantum peculiarity is not related to symmetric breaking. And also, there's a suggestion that a quantum breakdown QCP is indeed possible at mixed values. And another interesting suggestion is a topological phase transition at PC. And in this case, the partial motor localization of the F electron is occurring. And here, this is a schematic phase diagram. So in this vertical axis, this is the contour coupling. So this corresponds to the Doniak phase diagram. And if we add the other axis of the quantum fluctuation, then we may have quantum spin spin liquid metal. So the, our observation, what we observe in the pressure is probably the transition from spin liquid metal to the, this antiferromagnetic metal through this heavy film liquid, as shown here. And then another interesting suggestion have been made by Professor Pierce Coleman and colleagues, which is the anisotropic hybridization effect. And interestingly, in this system, the hybridization is supposed to have a node around the c-axis. This is coming from the crystalloid field ground state diagram near Solrio Jz equals plus minus 5 half. This is coming from the local YB side symmetry. And this crystalloid field ground state the scheme is this reproduced magnetic susceptibility. And if the hybridization have a node around the c-axis, then it has been suggested that this results in the two-dimensional heavy band with the dispersion with the k to the fourth. And this may explain the quantum criticality found in the beta phase if the F level is pinned down to the bottom of this heavy band. And this is the topological phase transition with a line defect in the momentum space. And indeed, we observe highly anisotropic density in the alpha YbAlB4. So here, this is the temperature dependence of the resistivity. And as you can see here, the imprint resistivity is much larger than the resistivity around c-axis. And the ratio is, ratio approach is 11 at a low temperature limit. And also the air coefficient of the T squared temperature dependence also reaches more than 10. So this is the strongest anisotropy among the heavy fermion systems. And consistent with the strong acidic hybridization in the AB plane, and also the hybridization node around CS. And we believe that the same isotope hybridization is also expected in the beta phase. However, the beta phase, the crystal has the crystal of the beta phase is quite very thin around the c-axis. It's only 20 or 10 micrometer thin. So we cannot measure the resistivity around the c-axis. So, however, maybe this is also the case in the beta phase. And another interesting observation is the two component Hall effect observed in beta phase. And here, this is the temperature dependence of the RH. And as you can see, it exhibits a peak at 40 Kelvin. And this means the coherent develops below 40 Kelvin. And more interestingly, ρxy exhibits a nonlinear behavior in against the magnetic field below 100 Kelvin. And this behavior can be well explained by two bound components, with the hole like component and electron like component with a low carrier density of the order of 10%. And this suggests that this electron like component corresponds to the responsible for the contrast behavior found in these systems. So to summarize, the alpha and beta YbAlB4 has exhibits a strong valence fluctuation with the characteristic temperature scale of the 300 Kelvin. In spite of this large, strong valence fluctuation, however, these two exhibit a contrast behavior with the temperature scale of the 8 Kelvin. And below this 8 Kelvin, while beta exhibit the quantum criticality without tuning and non-ferromagnetic behavior phase, just for balancing, extending up to 0.4 GPA. On the other hand, alpha exhibits anisotropic non-ferromagnetic behavior induced by magnetic field. And we think that here the topological aspects arising from the natural CF hybridization play an important role. I think the detailed study of the field geology, how it develops under field or pressure, is an interesting future issue. And also the relation to other systems like nucleotine or some hexaboride and 1 to 10 system is quite interesting. And next, I'd like to briefly mention about the topological aspect in the quantum spin ice system, plus it will be given to OSEP. So this is the metallic system. And in this case, plasteldium forms the particle lattice, and also the iridium forms the particle lattice. And the plasteldium has the local moment. On the other hand, the iridium supply a conduction region. And interestingly, long range of harmonic ordering have been observed except the partial spin freezing at the point. So you can shown here. And this system has the spin ice correlation, which can be confirmed by the metallic behavior, which has been observed only magnetic field under the magnetic field parallel to the 111 direction. And quite interesting observation is that the chiral spin leg state with a small tennis ball effect under B equals 0 and M equals 0. As you can see here, the sigma h exhibit a finite value even at zero field without having any magnetization. And this is quite interesting. And another interesting thing is the recent observations of the quadratic band touching of the 5D band. Another interesting thing, observation is the quantum critical behavior. The observation of the quantum critical behavior in the gamma H. Here, the gamma H is defined by this equation. So this is the magnetic curve effect divided by temperature. And this gamma H is supposed to diverge at any quantum critical point, and can be quite good sensitive probe to study the quantum critical point. And in this case, the gamma H exhibit the divergent behavior at least down to 0.4 Kelvin. And interestingly, it exhibits the T over B scaling. So this also indicates the zero field quantum critical is actually possibly stabilized by geometric frustration.
Well, the first part of the talk, what is the dependence of the T star compression?
Oh, T star under pressure.
Yes.
Sorry, I don't know. I think there are no big field the pressure dependence.
So it remains an APL.
Yes, I think so. But yeah, we have to confirm by using susceptibility under pressure, which has not been done yet.
But for the YbAlB4 high pressure, can you change the valence state? Can you see that with hot specs?
Oh. Yeah, we can, I think,
right, you have all this interesting non-permeable behavior in low pressures.
Yes, here?
Yeah.
But I think we still, so far we only have a resistivity there. But it takes a bit non-permeable behavior here. The exponent is, Yeah. I think it deviates from 2 if we measure.
Just that the window of this is very small, so that the actual like, sort of strength of the fluctuations are very weak there, relatively speaking, or?
Yeah. I think we have to fine tune the pressure. So far this exhibit the 2.0 and suddenly go down within the natural phase. So we have to confirm. But we believe that we can find the ordinary QCP, magnetic QCP here.
Yes. Okay. We will move on to the next speaker.